Yo, just a quickie today. It came off the back of an FE peer review video where he was analyzing footage from a guy named Pablo's dog. Right, so here's his comment at the bottom. The ridges and peaks to the right of George are like 1400 to 1500 feet elevation and can be readily compared to the elevation of the highest peaks and ridges to the left, which are like 2800 to 3000 feet elevation. Pretty much work out as 2 to 1 when measured on the screen. Meaning you're seeing most of the scene down to sea level, even if sea level plus minus is being hidden by upward refraction. All right, so what's he talking about here? So the red arrow is George's benchmark, and he's saying the terrain to the right of that is around 1400 to 1500 feet. The peaks on the left are around 3000 feet, and if you scale those two lines down to the horizon, then Pablo's dog claims you get roughly near enough to sea level. And just throw in a bit of upward refraction, and voila, Earth is flat. But we've got a bit of a conundrum here. If I'm Pablo's dog, where should I place this green line? So obviously, it has to go below George's benchmark because he says it's 500 feet taller than the peaks and ridges on the right, that he's claiming are 1400 to 1500 feet. But if we move the green line down from where it currently is, then his 2 to 1 scale starts to look a bit wonky, and starts looking a lot more like the base of those peaks is way below the horizon. So I think I've put it in the best possible position for Pablo's dog. And if we take that 3,000 feet on the left as given, and use the lower estimate of 1,400 feet for the stuff on the right, then maybe his argument makes a little bit of sense. Unfortunately for Pablo's dog, however, we can identify this little peak that the green arrow is pointing to. All we need to do is line up the screenshot in Google Earth and make sure the terrain matches and see where that line of sight ends up. So let's fade it in and out a couple of times. Right, so we follow that green line of sight at the bottom here, and it's literally just some dude's house up in the Malibu Hills. Unfortunately for Pablo's dog, it has an elevation of 1742 feet, not 1400 to 1500 feet. So if we now scale it properly, with the red line at 3000 feet and the green line at 1742 feet, the bad news for Pablo's dog is that it puts sea level for those mountains. Way down here. And I'm going to call that a problem for flat Earth. And just for shits and giggles, I'm going to demonstrate the curvature in a different way, which I'm going to call the helicopter method. So these two lines are obviously the lines of sight to George's benchmark, which is the light blue line, and the green line is the line of sight to the house up on top of the hill. Now, what I've done is draw that dark blue line perpendicular to those two sight lines. And just by pure coincidence, it measures 533 meters long, which is really close to the elevation of that house, which is 531 meters. And what I want you to imagine that dark blue line to represent is a helicopter carrying a big ruler, that's 533 meters long, which is what we measured between those two little peaks. So you'll see that the edges line up on the left and the right. Now, since the elevation of that house up on the hill is 531 meters, which is basically the same length as the ruler that the helicopter's carrying, all we need to do is cut one of those cables, and let that ruler swing vertically. And again, you'll get basically the same result, which is sea level at that distance is way below the horizon. And this technique isn't new. I've done it dozens of times in various videos, and you can apply it to pretty much any long distance image, especially stuff from beyond horizons. I just thought the helicopter analogy was a bit easier to understand. So here it is applied to the Blackpool Tower image, except in this case, we're going to adjust the length of the rulers to match the size of each mountain. Boom. So there you go, Flurfs. Curves everywhere if you know what you're doing, but that's a big if.